Welcome to Audio Video System Playlist. I, Professor Hitesh Dholakia, is going to explain you CCTV system in this session. So CCTV means closed circuit television system, and to understand CCTV system, these are my session outlines.
So first, I'll explain basics of CCTV system. Then after, I'll be explaining components which is there with CCTV system. After that, we will see basic block diagram which is there with CCTV system, and then I'll cover working of CCTV system, and at the end we will see applications of CCTV system. So CCTV system means closed circuit television system. So let us have beginning of this session with basics of CCTV system. So CCTV is also referred as video surveillance system. So for video surveillance, usually we use CCTV system, and full form of this CCTV is closed circuit television system. So as name suggests, it is mostly used for closed circuit monitoring using TV, or one can say monitor. So in some applications you will be finding there is one person who is watching video continuously on monitor by using CCTV system, and there are some applications where you don't have operator to watch monitor, but that video is continuously, it is going recorded by CCTV camera, and if some problems have happened, in that case we can review all those videos which is there with that given system. So that happened in closed circuit monitoring. See, first CCTV system was introduced by Siemens in Germany in 1942. So first CCTV system that was introduced by Siemens in Germany in 1942. See, later technology have evolved, and then after there was magnetic tape that was there for recording, but in that system you need to change that magnetic tape manually, and that was time consuming process, and it was even expensive as well as unreliable. So that system have failed later on, but nowadays you will be finding it consists memory hard drive to store video automatically. So previously there was magnetic tape that people were using it with CCTV system. So in magnetic tape you cannot reuse that once it is used completely. But once it is getting used, you need to change it manually, and that was time consuming. It was even expensive at that time period, and it was unreliable process. So at that time it was failed. It was used initially by Germany by using Siemens company in 1942. But nowadays in CCTV system you'll be finding there are so many other features which is available that makes use of CCTV reliable. So let us try to understand that step by step. So now I'll cover components of CCTV system, and then we will see block diagram of it. See, in CCTV system, these are the components. Obviously camera, that is a major component, and this camera that will be going to connected with monitor, and with monitor there will be switcher as well as memory drive. Switcher will switch different cameras, and memory drive that is used to store data of this camera. So let us see all those things in block diagram so it will be more clear. See, these are the cameras, one can see, and here these cameras are moving, you can see. So this CCTV camera can cover more area, and this CCTV cameras, that is connected with monitor. So here there is a monitor, and this monitor is connected with this different cameras, and with this monitor there will be a connection of switcher, and this switcher that is utilized to switch any camera. Like, see, for example, I want to view this camera. In that case, I need to switch this camera by using this switcher on this monitor, and one can view different region by sitting at one position. And even hard drive, or one can say memory drive, that is interfaced it with this monitor, where you'll be finding this memory drive that will be storing video information of all cameras, right? So anytime one can see data which was there in previous video shooting. Like, see, for example, if something have happened 2 days before, in that case we can even see all those things by memory storage which is there in this memory drive. So this memory drive, as well as quality of camera, that will justify for how much time period we can store video information. So that is even very important. Like, see, there are some CCTV system in which you can record a data for about 3 months, right? So that 3 months time period of video recording, that is depending on what is the size of this memory, as well as it is depending on what is the quality of this cameras. So based on quality of this camera as well as size of the memory, one can justify for how much time period we can store video information. And if operator is sitting over here, then that operator can monitor different areas by using this switcher, by switching one camera to other camera. So this is how this CCTV camera system is functioning. Now I'll explain you working. So as we have discussed, cameras are connected with monitor for observation. By switcher, we can switch one camera to other camera. Memory is used to store video information over here. And duration of storage of video information can be calculated by two factors. One is camera resolution and size of the memory. So if camera resolution is high, in that case, storage duration will decrease. And if size of memory is high, in that case, storage of duration will increase. So see, this is how, based on the requirement, we can use camera as well as memory for our applications. So let us discuss some applications here, which is there with CCTV camera. See, the basic application, that is crime prevention. So you'll be finding crime prevention, that is a very core issue which is there with humans, and for that CCTV cameras were used in so many public domain, like on railway platform, on airport. You will be finding always CCTV cameras were active, and that has been utilized for crime prevention. See, in industrial purpose even one can use it. Like, see, for example, if you have very big industrial business, in that case you cannot observe that continuously, you cannot monitor it continuously. So if you connect CCTV camera, you can even view it directly in your mobile screen. So at any time one can be connected to their business in industry. So in industrial purpose even one can use it for a watch or for observation, people are using that. In traffic monitoring, even CCTV cameras are used. And if you break the traffic rules, then this fine that can be given based on the observation which is there with CCTV camera. So traffic monitoring is even happening by having CCTV camera system. and for security purpose even we can use CCTV.
Thank you so much for watching this video. I would like to get your suggestions from your side. The reason is I want all those topics that has to be covered on my channel so that students can easily learn everything which is required in the university courses. And you can download all this material which I am teaching here from my application Engineering Funda. So I am providing all those material free of cost. You can download it. It will be easier to you to learn all those topic which I am teaching here. Again, thank you so much for watching this video and your suggestions are most welcome to me. So please do give your valuable suggestions which is highly required here to optimize this channel.